hard dice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 53 in our series, Create a RubyGem Nerd Dice. So in our last episode, we went through and modified the configuration class here for the ability to deal with the ability score related attributes. And we've got some repeated code that we'd like to refactor both in our a class itself and in the specs. So I'm going to go in the opposite direction and do the refactoring of the class first, make sure the specs still pass, and then I'll go in and modify the specs to reduce some of the repeated values there. So we've got a lot of items where we're checking for the new value being a positive integer. So let's create a private method. Our error message will be attribute name. In those cases, it will be a no method error that we're rescuing from. And if it's not positive, that should work. Make sure I don't have any syntax errors or anything. I don't. All right, let's start applying this now. Actually, we'll make this a bang method. Do it all the way down to except for in this case no longer needed. That is no longer needed. Make sure I did it right for that one. I did not. statement anymore. Still wrong. All right. Undefined method or nil. So that significantly cuts down on this. The other ones, I don't even need this part here. I just need the these other ones, rewrite them to one-liners. Sweet. And this is actually refresh seed interval. Think I can just do this similarly. Doesn't reduce the number of arguments or the line length or anything like that of that item. So leave that one alone. that leaves us with our remaining too long for RuboCop method. So all of this rescue but I've created a failure. That back to passing. That's looking good. Empty line after guard. Okay, those are standard road piracy. We'll let them correct my single quotes. They're still use guard clause instead of wrapping code inside of a conditional expression. 54. Return unless is what they want me to do there. I guess I can comply with that. Thank you. placated the officials. And everything is still passing. That is much better than it was. Alright, now let's turn our gaze toward the specs. Specifically, as it relates to these duck type integer attribute blocks and the other blocks. So in all these other cases, it's going to behave like a positive integer attribute setter. So let's create a new file. Got our new class here. And then we're going to want our spec.shared examples. Positive duck type integer attribute writer and a positive duck type integer attribute writer. So we want to take what we've got that's being repeated in this configuration spec and apply it to the shared examples. And some of these you can provide with variables. So if we look in the execute die roll spec there, we've got the ability to do a do end block, and that behaves like that lets us set any of the specifics. So let's try doing one of these. So positive duck type. Thank you. shared examples. This one can go in just any old attribute writer. Three will always be wrong, 11 building will always be wrong, 0 will always be wrong, and -6 will be always wrong. Everything else is just flat static. So we'll see. If we can get one of these to pass. Like attribute name. They're going to want double quotes. And then let's see, got to require it. So before we had 307 examples, now we have 307 examples. So I think that worked the way that I want it to. underscore array size. So that method I need to calling a different method on each one of these attributes. So let's take care of that. So attribute name, wonder if get us down to 3 failures, maybe? It does. Back to 307 examples and 0 failures. Let's continue down this path with the other 2. And then I anticipate that RuboCop might throw a conniption about me using send there, but we'll find out. And we'll do the same thing for fourth one. This one we still need to keep around that fifth one where it throws the error, but otherwise still got 307. See how RuboCop is doing here. Only 2. Empty block, which I can just take out at the end if we don't find a need for it. Now happy. So happy. All right. So we've got one more item I want to tackle, and that is the those are all still things that are attributes of a positive duct type attribute writer. Allows you to provide allows you to set the value, and it allows you to provide a numeric string. So I think for most of these you should be good to just continue doing this. Commit message. We will save it and sign it and push to the remote. Validate that everything is in good order. Everything is hunky-dory. We will go in and move our backlog item to done.
Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.